Hi, Assalamualaikum. My name is Nur Hanani binti Muhammad Hussein.
Amirah Mufisa binti Mak Ibuai.
Siti Nur Hafizah Rahimah binti Abdul Samad.
Nur Hamidah binti Anwari.
My student ID is 2023414516.
2023239416.
My student ID is 2023261814.
And my student ID is 2023689982.
Hi there! Do you know what digital health and wellness means? It refers to using digital technologies and tools to improve healthcare and personal well-being practices. This includes using things like telehealth services, wearable devices, mobile apps, and health data analysts. The goal is to use technology to provide better access to healthcare, promote proactive health management, and offer personalized solutions for physical and mental well-being. By using digital tools, individuals can monitor and improve their health and make more informed decisions about their healthcare. It's a way to connect people to healthcare resources and help them take charge of their health. Want to learn more about digital health and wellness? Let us serve you a simple short story. Hope you enjoy!
One eternity later. Later. The next morning.
What's wrong with you? I'm busy right now. Don't disturb me. Go away, go away. Cannot you see that? I'm playing games right now. Oh man! Hey, don't disturb me again. I say don't disturb me.
Using the phone for a long time is not good. So, it can give a bad impact on your health. But still I want to use it. No, you can't. It still can harm your health. So, what else I can do if I'm not using my phone? Like enjoying the nature.
Enjoying the nature?
Yes, we can appreciate our surrounding and it can be more entertaining.
Is that true?
That's true.
So, what else other than enjoying the nature?
Oh, there are many activities we can do other spending time on phone. Still, you can try out new hobby that gives benefit to you.
Alright, I get it now.
Hey, just look over there. There are birds flying with their group.
Oh, it's so amazing.
I think we have to go now.
Okay, let's go. What's time now? Never mind.
How is it? It's much better, right?
Yeah, it's much better than before.
Yes, finally, I can change her habit from too obsessed with gadgets to better lifestyle. I'm so relieved and too happy, hoping that she's still practicing this good lifestyle and become healthier each day.
So, how's the video? We really hope you like it.
From what you have watched, there are some of the things that you should and should not do. Let's go!
As you can see here, she keeps pressuring her shoulders by hunched over her body on a desk. This is definitely a big mistake.
By keep doing this, it can cause kyphosis, which is an excessive forward curve of our spine more than it should. Trust me, we are unable to maintain this position for a long time.
So, what is the correct position for sitting in a chair? But before that, have you guys ever heard an ergonomic design? No? Let me tell you then.
Actually, ergonomic is the one that you can stay easily for long hours with the minimum effort.
It is also have a good back and lumbar support, armrest and headrest. What makes it the best choice is all of these parts were flexible, adjustable and user-friendly.
But don't worry if you don't have any of this ergonomic chair because we can still sit properly using any chair. Some characteristics of an ergonomic chair is it is matches for our S-shaped spine line. Using any chair, all you need to do is just normally sit, lean your back,
and make sure your leg is on the floor by keep it at 90 degrees angle. Do not forget to take a break and change your position by standing or do some stretching. Lastly, you can enjoy your work happily and healthily.
From what we can see right now is an act of an individual who plays with her phone in the evening. Playing with our gadgets will eventually block us from doing other beneficial activity. This kind of behavior is considered not healthy because one is not making any physical movement, which will affect their own health if not prevented. Instead, you can get some fresh air and do some physical activities to reduce the risk of disease, strengthen your bones and muscles, and improve your brain health.
The situation shown here is what you should not when using the phone. Do not use phone in the dark room because the exposure to blue light at dark room can also contribute to eye strain, headache, and dry eyes. This is the right method while using the phone. Make sure to find a place with good lighting because it reduces the high probability on damaging your eyes. When you look at a cell phone screen in the dark, your pupils dilate to let in more light. This can make your eyes more sensitive to light and cause discomfort or temporary vision problems.
In conclusion, this digital transition not only changes the way life becomes more advanced, but also shows how one can engage with digital facilities without neglecting one's own health by adopting a healthy lifestyle through the examples that have been featured in this video. No matter how advanced the technology is today, it is important to be careful in using digital tools to avoid negative effects. With this digital transformation, all parties must take responsibility for healthcare, ultimately improving individual well-being and public health around the world. Last but not least, it is hoped that each of us can become a smarter digital citizenship as well as stay healthy and prosperous.
Misa, come join us! Misa, hurry up!